with your presence, fill me with your power, live inside of me. Welcome, Holy Spirit, be here with your presence, fill me with your power, live inside.
Hello and welcome to the program. My wife Sharon and I would love to welcome you today and thank you for tuning in. Our subject of discussion today is the person of the Holy Spirit. I would say that this area of the Holy Spirit is my favorite. I just love this mysterious person of the Holy Spirit. And you know, when I was a young Christian, I read a book by Catherine Kuhlman on the Holy Spirit, and I also read another book by Benny Hinn saying, Good Morning, Holy Spirit. And I've always been fascinated about the person of the Holy Spirit. And you know, Sharon, it's like, you know, I talk to many, many, many people, and somehow people don't understand really who the Holy Spirit is.
No.
I suppose the Father is easy to understand.
You can picture the Father on the throne,
On the throne.
Yeah.
And Jesus,
yes.
The Son.
We see Jesus through the Gospels.
Through the Gospel. But the Holy Spirit,
yes.
The Holy Spirit is almost a mystery.
What does he look like?
What does he look like? Yeah.
Yes.
And you get the impression that people think the Holy Spirit is like a dove.
Because he came as a dove, didn't he, when Jesus was baptized in the Spirit. John Baptist saw him as a dove.
As a dove. So people think, well, he's a dove, but he's not a dove, obviously.
No.
And also, he came like a mighty wind in Acts 2.
Yes.
It was a sound.
Pentecost.
Yeah.
There was a sound of a mighty rushing wind.
So, but yet he's not wind.
No.
And he also, the cloven tongues of fire were on people's heads.
Yes.
Baptism of fire.
So was he fire?
So he was fire. Then we think of the oil or water. So all these are symbols of the Holy Spirit, but it is not the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit actually is a person. And this is a hard concept to understand, the Spirit being a person, because he has no body as such. He has maybe a spirit body, but we don't know. The Bible doesn't show us.
No. And
the one thing that, you know, Sharon, that I recently discovered is why we don't have a lot of revelation about the person of the Holy Spirit is because the Holy Spirit doesn't speak of himself.
No.
He actually glorifies Jesus.
Yes.
He testifies of Jesus.
Yes.
He reveals Jesus to us.
Mm.
But he doesn't speak of himself.
Mm.
You know, he doesn't say, I, the Holy Spirit, I have come. No.
Yes.
So the Holy Spirit is a person. But we'll maybe start with the scripture verse.
Yeah.
In John 14, perhaps Sharon, you might want to read John 14.
Yeah.
I think 16 to 18. And
yes, go ahead. Verse 16, and I will pray the Father, and He will give you another Helper, that He may abide with you forever, the Spirit of Truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees Him nor knows Him. But you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you.
Now, it's interesting that Jesus is talking about the Comforter,
yes.
Or the Helper.
Yes.
Huh? And he's addressed in the He.
That's right. Not an it. Yes.
The Father shall give you another Comforter,
yes.
That he may abide with you forever.
Hmm.
So when you talk about the spirit person, if you're talking about somebody who's a he, it immediately implies a person. Otherwise, Jesus would have said, it will.
And it's the mystery of the Trinity, isn't it? Because God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. So how come they're all God, but they're all different?
Yes, I think it's a great mystery, but the three,
yes,
the three are one, but I always see that the three manifestations of God.
Right.
It's like you being a mother, a wife, and a daughter all at the same time, or me being a father, a son, and a husband. Three different
functions.
Almost three different people, really, but one person. So, but I think the Trinity is very difficult to understand, but I think we have to accept the Bible.
Yes, we can't understand it with our brains, can we?
Well, the Father was in heaven, and when Jesus was being baptized,
yes,
the Father spoke from heaven,
right,
saying, "This is my beloved Son," and the Holy Spirit came down upon Jesus. So, I mean, there are three. And so we just have to take it at that point.
Yes.
But the interesting subject we're discussing here is the person of the Holy Spirit.
Yes. What is he like?
What is he like?
Yeah. What is his character?
Well, his character. Okay. Now, he is portrayed as a dove. Now, that should give us an idea that he is very gentle. Very beautiful and very gentle.
And sensitive.
And very sensitive. Because doves, as you sensitive, know, are sensitive creatures.
Yes.
So the Holy Spirit is very sensitive,
yes,
very beautiful, and very gentle.
Yes.
But yet he is very powerful.
Wow. Yeah. Powerful. Yeah.
Because he created.
Yes.
The worlds.
Yes. It's like he was the acting part of God,
isn't
he?
Yes. God said, "The Spirit of God in Genesis. The Spirit of God is hovering over
the face of the deep."
And yeah. So when God said. Yeah. The Holy Spirit actually did the creating part. Let's see, let's look at Acts chapter 2, verse 1. And this is when the Holy Spirit actually came down, the day of Pentecost. Shall we like to read it? Acts 2, 1 to 4.
When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance.
So here we see how the Holy Spirit came down like a, well, mighty, it's a sound of a mighty wind. Well, it actually wasn't even a wind, but a sound of a mighty wind. But the important thing is that once we understand the Holy Spirit as being a person, then our relationship to Him changes.
Yes.
You know, it's like, you know, we used to sing songs like "Anointing Fall on Me," but it really doesn't make sense.
Nice song, but what does it mean?
Actually, the Holy Spirit falls on people.
Yes.
And the anointing is a byproduct of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
And I think once you can understand the Holy Spirit as a person, your whole Christian life does change. Absolutely changes. And, you know, you begin to relate to Him as a person. So, for example, I always ask people, you know, do you need help?
Yes.
And every hand goes up. Yes, I could use some help.
Yeah.
So I say, well, He has sent us the helper. So if you don't, if you realize the Holy Spirit is your helper, not just help, helper, you actually have a person.
It's one just like Jesus, isn't he?
He is called, one just like Jesus, come alongside us to help us. So, you know, Sharon, in reality...
So you should always be talking to the Holy Spirit then, asking Him for His help.
And therefore, if one like Jesus is alongside us, how can we lose? How can we live a defeated life?
Fail?
It's impossible to fail or to live in defeat. You know, it's like, imagine
God with us.
Yeah.
God in us.
Imagine Jesus physically walking with you day by day.
Yes.
I mean, you'd walk like a... You would walk with your head up high. You would be, man, you would never
fearless,
not a care in the world.
Yeah.
Anytime a problem, say, Jesus, you know, we run out of food, we need some money, and he just getting some money.
That's
that's what the disciples walked with Jesus. When they were in the wilderness, they had no food, Jesus multiplied the bread and the fish. When he was at the wedding, they ran out of wine,
that's right.
He turned the water into wine.
Yeah.
when they were in the boat and there was a storm, they turned immediately to Jesus and he spoke to the storm.
That's right.
And so wherever they were, the disciples, they immediately turned to Jesus for help.
Yes.
And they found help.
Yes.
Okay. Although Jesus always said, you know, where is your faith? Like, come on, guys, you know, use your faith now. Mm. How long do I have to be with you?
Yes.
You know, when they couldn't cast the devil out from this child. He said, how long?
Mm.
But so in the same way now, Jesus said, I'm going away,
yes.
but I'm sending you another helper.
Yes.
One like me.
Yes.
So therefore, when we have a problem, and I'm sure viewers
watching. We all have problems.
Problems. Any problem that you have, you actually go to the Holy Spirit and say, Dear Holy Spirit, I have this problem.
Yeah.
Can you please advise me? Because he's also a counselor, isn't he?
Yeah. And in your own life, have you experienced his help?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, even in this program, Sharon, you know, I said, Holy Spirit, I can't do all this. I can't convince anybody. I don't carry anything that will... But you are with me. You are in me. So you speak to the people.
That's
you help me on this television program.
Yeah.
You work through me
to
bless people.
Yes.
And
the truth is that we ourselves cannot convince anybody about Jesus, but it's the Holy Spirit, isn't it?
Yeah, the Holy Spirit convicts. Yeah.
So he will use what you say, but it's not your words that are going to affect anybody.
Exactly. Everybody knows, it's not by mind, not by power, by my spirit. But everything that pertains to life and ministry is by the power of the Holy Spirit. And once you realize that the Holy Spirit is a person, wow, you can actually relax.
Yes.
You can say, sweet Spirit of God, take charge, take control. You know, and see his marvelous power working. Yeah. I mean...
That's right. And sometimes you've got this problem in your life. It might be a sickness or it might be a financial. And you need wisdom. You just don't know what to do. And I have found in my life, he is the one that gives you the answers.
Because he is a revealer of truth.
Mm-hmm.
He reveals... I was talking to somebody who said, I don't understand the Bible. Well, the Bible is written by the Holy Spirit.
Yeah. That's
okay,
right.
So if you want to know what's in the Bible, you know, before you open the Bible, say, Dear Holy Spirit, reveal to me.
That's right. It can be, before I was filled with the Spirit, it was like a dead book. I couldn't understand it.
Now, one of the areas that people are always wanting is direction.
Yes.
You know, I mean, I meet countless people wanting direction, direction.
What shall I do, Lord?
The Bible says, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. But the Lord is in heaven, the Lord Jesus. But the Lord, the Holy Spirit, is on earth.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So the Holy Spirit guides us. Now, we can actually find it in Acts chapter 10.
Yep.
In Acts 10, verse 19 and 20, if you want to read that. Acts 10.
Yeah. While Peter thought about the vision, the Spirit said to him, Behold, three men are seeking you. Arise, therefore, go down and go with them, doubting nothing, for I have sent them.
Now, this is a very powerful scripture.
Mm.
The word, the very important word there is the word I. I have
sent
them.
Holy Spirit.
When you meditate on that word I have sent them, suddenly... The Holy Spirit becomes a real person to you. And then you become fearless. You know who to turn to in times. It's not like people say, looking up to heaven, it seems so far away.
Yeah.
Oh God, in heaven, help me.
We don't have a precise address for heaven either, do we?
No. But God is in us. We actually are God's address. Because why? We are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
So the Spirit of God, Sharon, the Spirit of God dwells in us. The greater one, greater is He that is in us than
He that's in the world.
Wow. So, I mean, the greater one is with us, so we can't fail.
And He said that He would never leave us, never forsake us.
He'll never.
He's always with us.
Yeah, the Holy Spirit will be with us forever.
And as you said before, He's going to guide us into all truth.
Again, I repeat, the reason people in the body of Christ don't know the Holy Spirit being as a person is because He doesn't speak of Himself. He speaks always of Jesus. He magnifies Jesus. Yeah. He glorifies Jesus. He testifies of Jesus.
Yes.
Another scripture we can read is in Acts chapter 8.
Mm-hmm.
Just one scripture, Acts chapter 8, and it's verse 29. Shall we read that?
Then the Spirit said to Philip, "Go near and overtake this chariot."
Okay, now it's a long story, you know, we only read one verse, but it's a story of Philip on the road to Gaza. And the Holy Spirit spoke to Philip and said, "Witness to this eunuch." The reason being, the eunuch was a very important man from Ethiopia.
Yeah.
And that's how the gospel came to that Ethiopia,
country.
Because Philip listened to the voice of the Holy Spirit, obeyed his voice.
But the Spirit speaks to us.
The Spirit speaks.
Yes.
See? The Spirit. So in every endeavor, whether it's your business, your family, or your children, you know, as we are depending on the voice of the Spirit, you know, my sheep hear my voice.
Yes.
The voice of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
As we are guided by the Holy Spirit, we would make better decisions. You know, how many of us have made a mess of our lives?
We have all made mistakes, I think.
Wrong decisions.
Haven't we? Yes.
We have done stuff, even this last couple of weeks.
Yes.
I took a decision that was in the flesh.
Yeah.
Pushing.
We can push things.
Pushing doors open, which were not meant to be, you know. I persuaded myself to be in a certain place. And on hindsight, I thought, oh dear, what am I doing here? It wasn't the Lord.
And we have an inward witness as well.
And
the peace of God.
The peace of God that passeth all. So we have a witness. The Holy Spirit will witness.
Yes.
You know, it's like sometimes, you know, there's a red light and a green light. Sometimes you come in a situation and you don't know what to do. You feel this red light in your heart. You feel something's not right here.
Yeah.
The Spirit of God who's in you, is talking to you. Now, how else do we know that the Holy Spirit is a person? Well, we know from Scripture the Holy Spirit can be grieved. Grieve not my spirit, the Bible, you know, the Bible says. And he is quenched.
Yes, you can quench him, you can resist the Holy Spirit.
You know, the Bible says, you talk about the children of Israel, you're always resisting the Holy Ghost.
Stubborn and stiff-necked people. So let's not be stubborn and stiff-necked.
Yeah, and so it's going to take time, I think. It's taken me years and years and years, Sharon,
to develop
a relationship.
And the trouble is, I always talk to the Holy Spirit, but unfortunately, I find him easy to forget during the day.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So it's always, oh, sorry, Holy Spirit, I forgot to talk to
That's
you.
That's right. To be conscious of, because I see, Jesus was very visible, physical. The Holy Spirit is an invisible. Okay, he's in us and he's around us. We are in him.
Yes.
So it's very easy to forget, because we are so used to living
five senses.
Five senses, right?
Yeah, what we see here.
Okay. So what I did was I copied Benny Hinn. Okay. Good morning, Holy Spirit. So in the morning, the first thing I would do is I say, "Good morning, Heavenly Father. Good morning, Lord Jesus." And good morning, or welcome, Holy Spirit. Please take charge of this day.
And I think the Holy Spirit as well, we're talking about him being gentle, and he's a gentleman, isn't he?
Absolutely.
He doesn't force his way on any of us.
No. We have to welcome him.
We have to ask
into our,
him. Yeah, he's not going to push his way on us.
No. That's why he's portrayed as a dove. You see, a dove is very easily frightened. And the Holy Spirit is not frightened. I mean, I mean, once the dove has been, upset or whatever, it doesn't come back to the same spot, I've been told.
Okay, just one question, though. When we're filled with the Holy Spirit, he comes to stay, doesn't he?
Absolutely.
And when we sin, what happens to the Holy Spirit?
Now, this is another area where people always tell me, you know, I don't feel God. I don't feel his presence. And one of the reasons that people don't feel God is because they grieve the Holy Spirit. You see, Sharon, you know, we live together.
Yes.
We're married, we live together.
Yeah.
Now, If I ignored you,
I would be grieved.
I mean, because you're a person. That's so right. Since the Holy Spirit is a person, he needs to be welcomed.
Right.
He needs to be obeyed.
Mm.
He needs to be involved in our day-to-day decisions. He needs to be, you know, acknowledged, honored. You know, in a meeting, you know, we can do a meeting.
We can do our own thing, can't we?
Three praise songs, two worship songs, a preacher, and we go home.
Yeah.
And the Holy Spirit will be completely ignored.
Yeah, it's like, hello, I'm here.
You know, the Holy Spirit is there. Maybe the Holy Spirit doesn't want any preaching today.
Well,
that would upset a few folks, wouldn't it? Maybe the Holy Spirit wants, you know, to change the subject matter. I mean, I always prepare a message, but at the same time...
You're flexible, though, aren't you?
Flexible. The Spirit of God knows who's coming, who you're going to meet, and what people need. And so, basically, we have to be open. Open to the Holy Spirit. You know, there's a scripture in 2 Corinthians 13:14.
Yes.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship, the sweet koinonia.
Yes, communion.
The communication
of the Holy Spirit.
So we are to what? Communicate.
Yes.
So I said, I want to say good morning, Holy Spirit.
That's right.
You know, I mean, you and I, the relationship we're supposed to have is an intimate relationship.
That's right.
You know, we discuss everything, don't
we? Well, we spend a lot of time together.
Yeah.
And so we know each other well.
Yeah.
Don't we? And we talk a lot.
Well, I talk.
Oh, yes. He talks. She listens. I listen. Mostly.
And we know each other. So when she's not feeling okay, you know, I can tell by her expression or vice versa.
Mm.
And so because we have a intimate relationship, and I think... That's the key to have an intimate relationship with the Holy Spirit. And I tell
you, which we need to develop.
Every problem in your life, every situation, every need for direction can be resolved. Because the Holy Spirit has all the answers to any question.
He does.
Your finances, your health, your family.
Yeah.
The Holy Spirit has the answer. Yeah. He knows. He is God, the Spirit.
Yes.
You know, and if he can't fix it, nobody else can fix it.
No, you know? No one else.
And
no,
so, anyway, as we wrap up this program, thank you so much for tuning in today. And please visit our website and say hello to us. At this time, I just want to take a minute to pray for you, pray for your needs, pray for your family. Whatever you're going through, the sweet Holy Spirit is with you. If you're a believer, born again, the Holy Ghost is there to help you and to assist you and to direct you. So I know many of you are facing tremendous challenges, many problems, many difficulties, financial problems, problems with family, friends, not knowing what to do, where to go. And some of you are perplexed. Some of you are just so feeling, don't know what to do. And so that's why I said, you know, we need to consult with the Holy Spirit. Consult with Him. So I'm going to pray for you right now that the Holy Ghost will visit you. If you're not filled with the Holy Spirit, He'll fill you right now. And so I want you to just stretch your hands out to me like this as a point of contact. And now receive from the sweet Spirit of God, the mighty Holy Spirit. He's there to heal your body. So be healed. Be made whole. There's somebody watching. You've been confused, you have all confusion in your mind. The Holy Ghost's power is coming and touching you and you're being healed. Your mind is being healed. Your mind is coming back to normal. You have a normal mind right now. The mind of Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, right. Just receive from the Spirit. Receive peace. There's some of you watching here so troubled. Receive the peace of God. The peace of God that comes by the Holy Spirit. You feel unloved. The Spirit of God brings love to you. Receive His love. Receive His comfort. Yes, you need direction. What do I do? Receive His direction by the Holy Spirit right now. Right now. God is giving you direction, illumination, revelation. You will know what to do by His Spirit. Some of you are saying, well, I've never heard His voice. Now begin to hear His voice. My sheep hear My voice and they follow. Hear His voice right now in the name of Jesus. If you've got pain in your body right now, I rebuke all pain. God is healing. somebody's leg, legs, a tremendous pain. You've had tremendous pain, both legs. God is healing you right now. Pain in your ears. God is healing you right now. A pain around your head. God is healing you right now. Just receive your healing. You've been barren. The Lord is speaking to somebody who's been barren. The Lord's going to give you not one, maybe two or three children. Receive that right now. You've been barren, and the Lord has opened your womb right now in the name of Jesus. God is doing it right now. Just receive it by faith, because it is the power of the Holy Spirit. It's not by might, not by power. By the Spirit of God. Supernatural, wonderful, beautiful, amazing. So receive the touch of the Holy Spirit. Be blessed in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Want to introduce some books that we have at our website, some wonderful material that will help you. Mm-hmm. Nothing, of course, can replace the Bible, but these books, mm-hmm. like this one by Yonggi Cho, The Fourth Dimension,
yes,
probably one of the best books I've ever read on faith.
Yes,
and
a classic
book.
Yeah.
And the other classic book that we really, really love is by Kenneth Hagin, yes. The Believer's Authority.
That's right.
And you found this amazing, isn't it, this book?
Yes, it is. We all need to know our authority in Christ.
And the third book that we would introduce by John Bevere. John Bevere wrote this book, has blessed millions of people in the area of unforgiveness.
Life-changing.
Life-changing. The Bait of Satan by John Bevere. And and finally, a book by Casey Treat.
Mm.
Casey Treat has 5,000 members. Written a book called Renewing the Mind.
Mm.
And that's really
the beginning place to start, is to renew your mind.
Yes.
And that's his subject.
Renewing the Mind, Casey Treat, great man of God. And so all these books are written by great men of God, and you can get them at our website. Mm. And also you can contact us, email, phone us, if you've got a prayer request or you want to just touch base with us.
Yes.
And let us know how you enjoy the program, because it's nothing like a little bit of feedback to say, hey, I watched the program, I really enjoyed it. And go to a website, all the it's on the screen, the information, the contact information. And we want to hear from you.
Yes.
And there's other books as well that you can get. Sharon CD, my books are on there. Visit the website and have a good browse around.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure you'll find something that will help you in your walk with Jesus. So until the next time, God bless you, and look forward to seeing you again. Bye-bye for now.
Fill me with your power, living inside.